Hey guys, Spencer Kaufman here with How To Video Channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make some foaming hand sanitizer. So this is awesome because a lot of times you have hand sanitizer and it's just in a gel or it's too runny and it goes all over the place or it burns or all kinds of different things. But today we're going to show you how to make it so it is foaming hand sanitizer. And you can do this at home with common everyday household ingredients. So the first thing you need is a foaming pump bottle. So you know a bottle is foaming if it has this big mechanism up here. It's a contraption that sucks up the liquid and turns it into foam and then pushes it out the top, etc. So if you don't have one of them, pick one up. Description below has links of all this stuff. You can get it there. So we've got the foaming pump bottle. Then alcohol. Now you can get 80% or 70% or 91%, but if you want to kill germs, get the highest percent possible because it's better. It'll kill more. Yes, okay, it may dry out your hands, but that's why they make lotion. So, foaming pump bottle, high percent rubbing alcohol. Then you'll want some essential oil. I got some lavender right here. Make it smell nice. And dish soap. Now you may say, wait a minute, dish soap. I don't want dish soap all over my hands. This is hand sanitizer. I'm not washing it off. I know you need the dish soap in order to activate it into foam. So you don't need much, just a little bit. In fact, we're gonna start out with the dish soap. So we'll pour it right in here. Not too much, only a little layer on the bottom. So about like that. Now, of course, it is going to be sudsy, so there are other methods that you could use. You could use Castile soap, which is also another type of soap. Pretty much you're going to need some type of soap in order to do this. If you use just regular aloe gel, it's not going to be foaming. It'll all come out liquidy. If you use alcohol, it'll come out liquidy. If you use hand sanitizer in there, it's going to come out liquidy. Feel free to try it. Put your comments in the description below. Once we've got our soap in there, we're going to pour in the rubbing alcohol. So I'll just unscrew the top because we're not going to dink around with squirting it all in there. And we're going to fill this right up to the top. Then we need a scent. So like I said, I've got some aloe vera, not some aloe vera, I have some lavender. So lavender essential oil, you could use whatever flavor you like. I'm going to put in about 10 drops. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Ooh. Okay. Now we're going to give it a test. So we'll take the pump mechanism. Looks like I filled it a little too full. Let's open it up a bit. Oh. Yeah, a little too full. No big deal. It'll all clean right up. Grab a little towel quick. Put that there. Okay. And we're going to test it. So let me tip it, kind of get it mixed in. You can see it's all wavy there. It's mixing. All right, let's give it a test. Okay, it's liquidy. That's pretty liquidy. So that means you need more soap. So no big deal. You just do some trial and error back and forth with more soap. So let's pour a little bit out into a container and we will add more soap to get the right consistency. So pour a little of this out and add a little more soap. And we're going to try it again. There it is. That's foam. And see how it just pretty much evaporates like that? That's the alcohol evaporating. You can rub it into your hands. And the air evaporates it. Let's let it dry. We're going to see if it feels slippery and slimy like soap or if it actually evaporates. So, it's evaporating. And that's it. My hands don't feel dry and cracked or anything. But I suppose if you used it a lot, they would. That is how you can make foaming pump hand sanitizer. So you are going to do some trial and error with the soap. If you get too much soap in here, it's not going to be good because it's going to be slimy all over your hands. That's why I took a couple of tries to get there because I didn't want to put too much soap in. So keep that in mind. When you are mixing these proportions together, if you get too much soap in there and try it and it becomes all slimy on your hands, then take this, put it in a bathroom, and let people use it to wash their hands until you use it up, or get another pump bottle, try again. But you don't need to waste it. You can still use it as foaming soap. Just won't be foaming hand sanitizer because your hands are going to be all grimy after you use it. So keep that in mind. Try out some different proportions. I've also tried different things like coconut oil, or you can use olive oil instead of soap. None of it really works very well. You need something that's thick like soap. So unfortunately, that's the way it is. You could, like I said, try those different types of soaps, but bottom line is it's still all soap if you want the foaming hand sanitizer. Now, if you have a different method or an idea that you think might work, feel free to post that in the comments below, and I can start doing some experimenting and find the perfect method to make it happen without the use of soap. So feel free to comment below. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Comment below telling us you subscribed. And again, hit that like button as well as the bell icon to stay tuned for future videos. Thank you.